Welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. I had on the How to Buy Your Smoker video, last one I uploaded, and on the live feed we were talking about pellet smokers and puck type smokers where they drop the pucks in. Jeff Pershawn, if I said that right, has a Cook Shack brand smoker which uses the pellets, and one thing that I think Russ had mentioned, that what kind of binders are used to form these pellets that the smoker used for smoking wood. Cook Shack, who makes the smoke, makes a pellet smoker, and Barbecue Delight and Lumberjack are the brands of smoke suppliers. These three here, their pellets are 100%, like if you buy a hickory pellet from them, it's 100% hickory, no binders or fillers. Same way with Barbecue Delight and Lumberjack. Others, lesser expensive pellets, are 40% of the flavor of wood of your choice, and they put 60% oak in there too to save money. So are you getting a better deal or are you getting screwed blue? And don't use pellets that are for heating, because they lubricate, they gotta keep their machines lubricated, and they don't necessarily use a food grade grease to lubricate their equipment that forms the pellets. Cooking pellets have to use that food grade grease. All right, now you know. Or have to be made using food grade grease on their machines. What I was gonna say, you know that I mentioned it in the How to Buy a Smoker video. One called a upright drum smoker. Some people call them ugly drum smoker. Normally that's because the paint kind of burns off by the firebox and it ain't so pretty no more. You can build one, but you're really supposed to buy a brand new drum that's had no chemicals in it. The 55-gallon drum I'm talking about. Or if you can buy a 55-gallon drum that had something that was made or cleaned for food grade shipment, like it was a new drum, somebody filled it with cooking oil, you could use that. You really shouldn't try to get some kind of other chemical out of a drum. You're taking your life into your own hands. And my friend, I think his name is Claude, over at hogfathers.com, Hogfathers Barbecue, but it's Hog, H-A-W-G, I think is the way the site's spelled, Hogfathers. I'll put a link in the description box to it, but he's got plans and how to and everything about how to build a upright drum smoker if you're handy with wood and everything. And if you got to buy everything brand new and you don't have some of the stuff laying around, it can cost you $300. They work great. Buy a brand new Weber for $300. And they work great too, and you don't have to build it. So, anyway. Alright. I'm going to go drink some more pop. Oh, JB had a life-threatening experience the other night. Me and Miss JB was going over to one of my employees' new house for a party. And out in the country, we had to stop and get gas at a little country gas station. And I was drinking a pop. And then she would need to get some gas in my pickup truck. Her pop was empty. So I rolled the window down and chunked it in the back of the truck. The wind was blowing real hard. and I was in the passenger seat. I ain't hear that clink sound when they land in the back of the truck. I heard a cook and son of a bitch. Uh-oh. Miss JB say that. The door opened to the truck. That can hit me in the head. I'm like, oh shit, I'm sorry. It's the wind's fault. I didn't compensate for the wind. Boy, she was pissed. Her eyes was all red. You see the fire was like, she was snorting fire. She was pissed. I'm like, oh shit, I'm so sorry, man. Look, I didn't compensate for the wind. You knew she packed that pistol with her. Oh man, I thought I was finna die. So I'm sorry. That's all I could think of. Not my fault. Then she told me later that when it hit her in the head, beer kind of splattered everywhere. Is there a little bit left in the can, you know? Yeah, I cocked it right on the forehead, too. I was trying not to laugh at the same time, but I was getting ready to get out the truck and haul ass. But she shoot good. I'd have got a bullet in the butt, I'm sure. I had to calm her down, but we made it. I'm still here, luckily. Yeah, I've seen all 9 lives run across my eyes at that point. I'm like, oh no. She was pissed off to the highest level of pissedivity. I can tell you that now. Damn.
I hear it ticking.
Must be a bomb. Oh no. Hey girl. Wait a minute, I'm gonna come jog with you. Shit. I may not make it back. Oh, sorry. He was recording, Cammy. You getting non-union, you know that?